Hello and welcome back. There are so many designs in the market, the designer suits with the lining or the half lining, and in this video I show you how to make half lining suit. But please subscribe and press the bell button so you don't miss any of the latest videos and uploads. These are the measurements. You can check your measurements and based on that note them down in a piece of paper. Now it's better that you wash your suit before we start cutting, but if you think the color may bleed, then don't wash that. Get it dry clean, then remove the pieces. If the length is more, remove the border. If the back side, that is also to be removed. This is the border, the extra one that I just removed. And this one, the front is stitched with the lining. I'm not removing the lining. I folded it and pressed it. Generally, the neck and the neckline is already made on semi-stitched suits. So we just check how deep we want it. Then we mark the shoulder. The neck deep, how much you need. Based on that, start marking the armhole, waist length, hip length, and the total length. If there is border, generally we don't need to fold from the bottom, so we are not adding anything extra. Then we extend these markings. You can pause this video and note down the formulas. We extend these markings, chest, hip, waist, and then as per the formula, just adding half inch. And then from shoulder, on the chest line, we take 1 inch lesser than the shoulder, join it. Shape the front armhole. From the side also you join. And same as hip, you can mark for the bottom. Or if you want it A-line, you can keep 2.5 inch more than the hip line. We extend 1 inch on the sides for the seams. This will be folded. Give it a shape from the side. We mark for the seam on the stitching line. We press the tracing wheel. We are cutting front only. Now we cut on the outer drafting or marking. Make small cuts. Now we cut the back by keeping this front. This is the back part we had already separated, pressed it, folded it, and now keep the front. The armhole of the back would be 1/2 inch more than the front. The back neckline is 2 inch deep. I just shape it. The neck width is 3 inch. I'm keeping it 2 inch deep, but you can keep it till 7 or 8 if you keep it deeper. Then the shoulder would be lesser or reduced by 1/2 inch. Now the back part would be extended by a few inches because that will be folded. Now we cut the sleeves. We cut both the sleeves together. Fold the fabric. Press it. This is the border part that we'll use to increase the length of the sleeve. Whatever length you want for your sleeve, you can check that. Keep 1 inch extra, half for the seam, half for the border seams. Keep armhole same as you kept for the suit or the kurti, 3 inch inside. Keep 1 inch down from up. Make a slanting line. Take a middle point, shape it, curve it from the out, half shape from down, and then join it from the up. Now check your bottom round of the sleeve. What you want? I wanted 5, so I mark it 5. You can keep even more. Now join it from the side of the armhole. You can use even the curvier or leg scale, or simply give it a shape with a chalk. Keep 1 inch on the side for the seams. Now we cut these sleeves. This is the tracing wheel we use so that we know what are the stitching lines. Cut only on the outer lines. Make a small notch on top of the sleeve. Small notch on side of the sleeve. Now we open it to cut the curvier side of the sleeve, that is the front side of the sleeve. Front is different curvier than the back of the sleeve. So here we got two sleeves marked so that it is easier to know what is the right and what is the back. Please subscribe so that you could get the stitching video of this part. That would be the second one. So take care. Goodbye.